Welcome back to Character Elimination, No Way Home. Since the Fiesta musicians lost, one of our co-hosts, as voted by the viewers, has to go host the elimination and hand out the prizes. So, what do you think James Allmendinger is gonna look like? I don't know, but I hope he looks better than how he looked like the last time we saw him. Oh, and here he comes now. Ah, everyone, so glad you could join me here. Well, it's been a while, Allmendinger. Well, I'm impressed. Yeah, thanks. But don't worry about it. I'll explain everything later. Right now, my friend, real life Jacob, don't we have an elimination to do? Yes, in fact, we do. In fact, we were just heading over there now. On a similar note, let's do cake at stake. Hello, contestants. I'm Lenny Loud, and I'll be your elimination announcer for this episode. Last time you guys lost, and whichever of you gets the most elimination votes will be going home. And I know that one of us will win the prize, but real question, where are you, the host, and the other three? Oh, don't worry, we'll explain that later on. So, in the meantime, whoever doesn't get one of the 9 donuts that Martin Coleman has with him will be eliminated. And there's no need for Amigo to worry because he has immunity. And also, one person got all 10 votes. The 8 people safe are Alicia, Dora, Scootaloo, Sunburn, Bianca, Fox, Doctor Strange, and Villager.
Oh no! Does this mean?
Yeah. Sorry, Treadhead, but you've been eliminated from the game. And also, Alicia won the prize.
That is correct, and I've been advised to say that Alicia's prize is a -3 elimination vote advantage the next time if the Fiesta musicians are up for elimination. Well, I may be out of the game, but at least I didn't go home first. Guys, good luck.
I'm off to find Pen Zero and his hotel.
Alright, everyone. This next challenge is going to involve the Talladega Super Speedway, the most unpredictable NASCAR track on the NASCAR schedule, home to great finishes, amazing crashes, and, fun fact, the playoffs race in 2021 was rain delayed on Sunday, so it was pushed back to Monday. And since it was a school day on that day, I was eager to see the race from I checked online and during the day, and I ran all the way back to my house to watch it, and in the end, Bubba Wallace won the race in the 23 for E. The first one, and it was the first win in 23-11 racings and it was the first win for 23-11 racing, and it had McDonald's as a sponsor. Just wanted to point that out. Anyway, enough about that. It's time for some challenge. The third challenge of the season is going to involve the team captains. As everyone already knows, Lola Loud, Violet the Wolf, Wonder Red, True, Amigo, and Dorothy were chosen as the team captains. so they will be the ones competing in this challenge. They will each be given a stock car, and I will not say which ones they will get, after they receive them, they will have a 5-lap dash. The rest of their team will stay in pit road, and during the 5-lap dash, they'll have to make a green flag pit stop. And the first person to finish their 5 laps will win. But the one who finishes last place will cause their team to be up for elimination. But this isn't going to affect the team captain because 4 out of the 6 of them will have immunity. So anyways, let's get those cars and get going. All right. Now let's see who we are now in the victory lane. Now let's see the results. It appears that Lola Loud has placed first and follow, so that means the beautiful princesses win, but it looks like the Rainbow Kingdom Wishmasters have placed last, and that means that they will be sending someone home. However, True will be the exception to this because she's the team captain and she gets immunity for this elimination. So viewers, it's on to you. Vote for who to be eliminated and for who to win the prize, but don't vote for True for either or your votes will not count. And don't forget to vote for either Twyla Boogeyman or Kevin Harvick to host the elimination and to hand out the prizes. You know, guys, if it wasn't for True, we would have lost and one of us would have been eliminated by a much more dishonorable amount. But Matt, we did still lose, did we? Yes, thanks Apple Bloom. And I guess next episode we'll be forced to bid either Eep Cheep Toby or Robotti farewell. What? Why them? Well, obviously Rarity, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm not sure how long Robotti might last in this season, despite, again, far in seasons 43 and 47. Great job, by the way. Great job to him, by the way. I'm not sure how long Eep Cheep is going to stick around. And Toby, popularity isn't everything, despite you being a popular character. Well, no worries. An early elimination happened to me before. Oh, really? Didn't know that. But whatever the case, but we're missing the point of all of this. One of us will be eliminated with dignity next episode, and that's all that matters. Speaking of which, I have a bad feeling that we're going to encounter the Emsers soon. Looks like James Allmendinger made a somewhat return, but let's see if he sticks around. And Matt's right. Throughout this journey, will they encounter the Emsers? The only way to find out is to keep on watching. So we'll see them soon on Character Elimination No Way Home. Stay tuned to see what happens next, everyone, and we will see you next time.